Hello everyone, I'm back with another set of DIY activities using my favorite dot stickers. So here are the three activities which I'm going to share. All are DIYs drawn on the papers. I have actually the activities which my kids are outgrown. So cutouts I can still use for as a cards, but the sheets were there, so I used them. With the permanent markers, they are probably only one time usable because they are using dot stickers, so I don't think you can remove them. So I've not done with my kids yet, but probably a one time usable activity, so just draw on a white paper, that should work out. So I explain the logic of these three dot stickers activities. The first one is direction one. Okay, so wherever the she sees the arrow going up, she has to put pink. Arrow going down, she has to put yellow. Arrow going right, she has to put green. And arrow going left, has to put blue. Okay, so this is a visual discrimination as well as logic and focus activity. So if you think that this is complex for your child, it's too big, so just create not 2x2 version initially. It's mine is 6x5 because I have done similar kind of activity when she was nearby 2 years old and she did well. So that was 4 to 5 boxes only she had to fill. So this is because to be 4 year old, so I created a very complex version. You can also do one more thing, that you know, rather than creating 4 variables, you can use only 2 variables. Okay, so like only upward and going downward arrow, so don't confuse the child with these two. So you can create many simpler versions of this one using these dot stickers and analyzing how much a child is capable of, and then probably, you know, increasing the complexity level one by one, because anyway they are one time usable, so you have to create another activity. That's one. This is alphabet. So this is a 2 year old cannot peel off the dot stickers from such sheets as such, so I have to remove these sheets all the time so that she can use those dot stickers for various games and all. So this sheet, when the dot stickers are left on that sticker book, and this is waste, so I stick it here, and because my 4 year old still get confused between bird and purr, so I just wrote different alphabets inside it. They're just to create confusion, okay, because these are very smart kids. They know that mama has given 12 stickers or 10 stickers. Definitely they'll fit somewhere. So that's why I have created random alphabets also, which will not have any sticker. So again, she has to recognize this. B has to put pink, D green, P and yellow. So like that, she has to use the stickers, recognize the alphabets, look at the logic down and put the stickers. This last one is again direction based. So, you know, the same sheet, but I have cut it in particular angles. So, this is being cut. We have to go from dot to star. So this is going down and then right. This has to go up and then left. And again, they're different direction, going up like that and directly going up. So on these dot stickers, I have marked the directions, okay? So like if she has to go from here to here, she has to go down. So she has to use these arrows, okay, which are going down. And then she has something which goes like this, you know, like this, the arrow should say. So then she has to look for that sticker, which like for probably this one will go here, and then you can go from here to here. So again, it's focus and logic and visual discrimination kind of, because you know they have to really look at which arrow go which direction. So they are the three stickers based activities, one time usable, I think so. And so completely do it DIY. You don't waste money in laminating or anything, like just a white sheet of paper. I have used permanent markers and simple dot stickers. So hope you enjoyed this, and bye bye.